New police minister has been warned by SAPTU. SAPTU guys is a union for police in South Africa. So they warned him and they said, listen, it will do you good if you stay in your lane and you don't disrupt operational processes. You just stick to your lane. It will do you good. We do not want ministers who are coming to the police to disturb the processes here. No. Stick or remain in your lane. It will do you good. It's not what I said. No, guys. It's not what I said. It's what they said here, as quoted by East Sowetan Live, right? There's an article there that was released. So let's have a look at the article. It says, Mkhunu must walk in his lane and not interfere with operational police business. It's not your business. Union condemn president for retaining deputy minister Kassal Mashel, right? In an article written by Uma Libongwe, Daiman. Hey, yes, I said Daiman. They say, Mkhun, remain and stick to your lane. Not what I said, former minister of what, water and sanitation. They are like, hey, we babu Mkhun. Say at elabo, awukhlale lane in yakho. Senzo Mkhun. The South African Police Union, SAPTU, has warned newly appointed police minister Senzo Mkhunu to stay on his lane and not to try to interfere with operational matters of police. The question is, if they are saying that, does it mean that the previous one was interfering with the process, such processes? It's just a fair question to ask. Does it mean that the previous one was interfering with such processes? Well, I know you say, but who's the previous one? Well, the previous one is none other than Luku Pegs in Tile. Well, you know, the reason I'm laughing is because thinking of Peggy Tile, right? Or speaking of Peggy Tile, some other people say he got fired. Now he's preparing for his Maskandi album. They are saying he's preparing to release his first Maskandi album because now he's unemployed. So Peggy Tele has found his way into the music as ever since he got. Hey guys, have you not seen the pictures of Tele there circulating with his album and the guitar? Right. Oh guys, it's not me. It's not his people. But nevertheless, let me unpack all of this, right? Before we do so, guys, wait a minute. Why are you not... If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
All right, so let's proceed. They say the union said this day, the union said this a day after President Ramaphosa announced a new cabinet on Sunday night. Ramaphosa appointed Mkhunu as a new police minister, Peter Groenewald as the new Minister of Correctional Service, and isn't Kassal Mashel and Connie Baitelo as Mkhunu's deputies, right? Also, why do they have two deputies? It's just, while the union welcome Mkhunu at the helm, they have a stand. Should we even say stand? Maybe stand, yeah. it carries the sense of agency, the sense of hey, where, you know what I'm saying? Carries this. They say, the union says, SAPU calls for minister. It says, SAPU calls. SAPU commends the president for retaining Deputy Minister Khasal Mashal as an institutional memory of paramount importance in terms of taking the ministry forward. The union also said the new ministry needs to hit the ground running. They said, the time of celebration has long passed. Both members and the communities are expecting nothing less but the job to be done as a matter of extreme urgency. This is a new beginning. Let us all join hands and as communities are keenly waiting for improved service delivery. Yay. I think they said something quite meaningful there. Like, honestly speaking, whether the minister is appointed yesterday, tomorrow, today, it does not matter. The relationship between communities and the minister is how it's on the basis of how you deliver service delivery. Nothing more, nothing less. But yeah, as quoted by Sunday World, meanwhile, police, local prison and civil rights union pop crew has challenged the new minister in charge of police, prison and constitutional development to speedily stop the killing of law enforcement officers, address the prison overcrowding, and declare police murderers treasonous. Oh. So in other words, they are saying, if you kill a police, it's a serious offense that you will not be charged as a... You will not be charged like anybody else. Say, for instance, in the Constitution, if you murder, there's a way in which they measure your case to say, okay, it falls within the schedule. You know what I'm saying? So whether you murder the police or what, but it falls within that. So because it falls within that, so you get charged in the normal way. So what they are saying is that if you kill a police, you'll be charged differently. Yeah, it is going to be considered the worst and the serious crime ever. I don't know if I agree to that. I don't know. But maybe I will hear from you. Popular calls for the government to act harsher against police murderers comes on the backdrop of murder of Eastern Cape police officer who was gunned down in a cold blood during an ambush. Mount Flare. The constable was shot dead at around about 8:30 p.m. on Thursday while on duty. The union said, we reaffirm our call for the government to publish and declare war against cold-blooded criminals by amending current legislation to classify this barbaric act as treasonous, right? And expect a newly appointed minister to push for legislative amendment in this regard. I'll be keen to know Uguti, if it passes, how is it gonna work? But to pass a bill, it's not like they need something extraordinary. But let's capture this last statement from them. They said, for the longest time, the union has been concerned about the frequent changes in the ministerial and other leadership positions, which have led to policy discontinuity. Popro is concerned about maintaining stability, continuity in crucial reform processes such as Criminal Procedure Act already underway, and therefore stresses the importance of long-term vision that transcend individual tension and focuses on sustainable improvement, the union said. It is quite interesting, right? It is very, 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 very interesting. But I'll say the points that they are raising are very important, like continuity. You can't have this person planning this and the other one changing that and the other. You know, there must be continuity. You are just confusing people in the process. I fully concur with them.